Jay here with FCP Euro, and today I'm going to show you how to replace front and rear brake calipers, as well as rotors, pads, hoses, and hardware on this 2004 Volvo S60. Let's begin. For this video, I'm using Zimmerman coated rotors, Techstar semi-metallic pads, some remanufactured calipers. You're going to note that they're bright silver. I took the time to use some Scotch-Brite, go over the calipers, sand them down, give a nice rough surface, and go over it with some high-temp caliper paint. Painting your calipers gives it a nice cleaner look and presentation. Support the car up in the air and remove the wheels. First, remove the anti-rattle spring. I'm using a flathead screwdriver. Now remove the 2 millimeter Allen's. Now use a 13 millimeter wrench, and we're going to crack open the hard line that goes into the brake hose. Make sure you have a catch can underneath, because brake fluid will drip out. Now with the hose disconnected, remove the caliper from the vehicle. Now remove the 2 15 millimeter bolts that hold the caliper bracket in place. Now remove your rotor. It's 1 10 millimeter bolt. Now I'm going to clean up the hub surface. Now reinstall your front rotor. Your caliper hold down bracket. And the steering stop bracket. All right, now time to install our front calipers. Just a little tip, always push the hold down bolts back so it doesn't interfere. Also, good time to install your inner pad. You're gonna notice I applied some silicone grease to the back. Also good time to install the outer pad. And you're gonna notice that I also installed the brake hose onto the caliper first. And that's gonna help you so you don't get a twisting condition later on. Now that the brake hose has been tightened, go ahead and install your caliper bolts. Now install the caps on the back of the caliper bolts. And last, your brake spring. Now that you're done with the front left, repeat the process on the right front. It's always best to replace these things in pairs. We've already gone ahead and done so on the passenger side. Now we're going to move to the back. Normally the first thing we would do is remove the anti-rattle clip spring. Unfortunately, this car was missing it, so we're gonna go ahead and add that back in when we put everything back together. I'm gonna skip this step now because I physically can't do it. Remove the 2 caps for the caliper bolts. For the extension. And the same 7 millimeter Allen going from the rear. This brake hose appears to be in really good shape, so we're going to leave it on the car. Remove the ABS sensor plastic brackets from the hose and crack the hose loose from the caliper. And remove the caliper. Now remove the pad. And the 2 13 millimeter bolts for the caliper hold down bracket. I remove the set screw, 10 millimeter for the rotor. I remove the rotor. Now's a good time to inspect your parking brake shoes, make sure they're in good working order. Our shoes appear to have a lot of meat left on them, so we're gonna go ahead and leave them at this time. Now install your rotor. Your 10 millimeter set screw. Now your caliper hold down bracket. Tighten your 2 13 millimeter caliper bracket hold down bolts. Now spin on your caliper. Install your outer pad and your inner pad. Put your caliper back into position. Now tighten your caliper bolts.
Now tighten your hose.
Notice the natural curve of the hose. If you install your hose and it's kinked and looped around, you have to redo it because it's installed improperly. Now we're just going to snap in our ABS wire hose. Now install your rear spring. All right, so we just finished up the rear brakes on the driver's side rear. We're going to use our volunteer Nate, our director of motorsports here. He's going to go inside the car. He's going to pump the brakes while we bleed him. We're going to start closest to the master and work our way back. Volvo's a little backwards compared to other manufacturers.
Now let's make sure we have an adequate amount of fluid in the master.
All right, so we have Nate in the car. He's going to be pumping our brakes for us. We're going to start in the left front wheel. We've attached a clear hose in the catch can, and it's a 10 millimeter wrench to crack open the bleeders. So I'm going to ask Nate, pump three times and hold, please. And he's pushing down the pedal, and on the third push, he's going to hold it down. And you can see fluid coming down. One more time, Nate, please. Okay. So we're going to tighten that up and move to the passenger front wheel.
One, two, three.
You'll see all the air coming out. Pump. Pump. Holding?
Yep.
At this time, it's probably not a bad idea as you're going through all the wheels to make sure that you're not running the master cylinder reservoir dry. Yeah, we just checked and we have adequate amount of fluid. So we're on our last caliper, which is the passenger side rear. Pump.
Now top off your brake fluid.
Now install all your wheels. All right guys, and that's how you replace the calipers on this 2004 Volvo S60. You can apply this video to all the other P2 chassis models. If you have any additional comments or questions, comment in the box below. And don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you.